our church. We are redeemed and chosen, trusting in the God of love, the God of hope, the God of atonement. We are church. We believe in one way, one truth, one life. Devoted, eyes fixed on the prize, devoted to Christ. We are church. We put God first. We are like-minded people created in Christ for good works, made in the image of greatness, made to reflect the greatest love ever known. We are church, the light in the dark, the hope to the hopeless, a brand new start, peace for the broken heart, a love that has open arms. We are church. Not four walls. We are a body of believers following the call to know we are forgiven, the call to love without condition, the call to trust without division. We are church, a community with open doors, serving the poor, living for more. We are broken people with a united cause, an unbroken love in a divided society proclaiming Jesus is.
Worthy God, worthy God, worthy God. For the Lord is good. His mercy is everlasting. And his truth endureth. Hallelujah. To all generations. Come on, somebody. Let him get in your praise. Let him dwell in your praise. He's worthy. He's worthy. He's worthy. Hallelujah. Thank you.
Good morning and happy Sabbath to everyone present. We do hope and pray that you have a wonderful time sitting with us today. We do want to welcome you and thank you for being here. And as we celebrate today with Sister Richardson, we do hope and pray that this will be a memorable occasion and that God will descend and bless us and we will leave here feeling spirit-filled. Before we begin, we would like you to bow your heads for a word of prayer. Dear God, we thank you this morning for waking us up and giving us health and strength in our bones so that we can be here in your house of worship. Lord, as we begin to sing, may the praises go up and may the blessings flow down. Be with each and every one of us. May we glorify your name to the best of our ability. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. We will start with the chorus. We're together again, praising the Lord. The time to be happy is now. We shall have a grand time up in heaven, and then no grave gonna keep my body down.
We're together again, praising the Lord. We're together again. To happen, something good is on its way. We're together again, praising the Lord. We're together again, praising the Lord. We're together again. To happen, something good is this way. We're together again, praising the Lord. The time to be happy is now, and the place to be happy is here, and the way to be happy is to make us happy, and we'll have a little heaven down here. Oh yeah, oh yes, there is something more than gold. Oh yes, oh yes, there is something more than gold in my soul. There is something more than gold. Time to be happy is now, and the place to be happy is here, and the way to be happy is to make others happy, and we'll have a little heaven down here. Oh yes, oh yes, there is something more than gold. Oh yes, oh yes, there is something more than gold in my soul. There is something more than gold. We shall have a grand time up in heaven. We shall have a grand time up in heaven. Have a grand time walking with the angels. Up in heaven, have a grand time. Oh, we shall have a grand time. Up in heaven, we shall have a grand time. Up in heaven, have a grand time. Walking with the angels.
We shall have a grand time. Up in heaven, have a grand time.
No grave gonna hold my body down.
Oh,
We'll now continue with the hymn, The Lord Jehovah Reigns.
The Lord Jehovah Reigns.
The Lord Jehovah reigns, His throne is built on high, the garments He assumed are light and majesty.
We'll sing as hymn number 524. 'Tis so sweet to trust in Jesus. Now turn to hymn number 423, our opening hymn. At the indication of the instruments, we shall stand and sing together. 423, glorious things of thee are spoken. Stand as we sing.
Glorious things of thee are spoken, Zion city of our God. He whose word cannot be broken, formed thee for his own abode. On the rock of ages founded, what can shake thy sure report? With sufficient walls around it, thou mayst smile at all thy foes. See the streams of living waters springing from the eternal love. We'll supply thy sons and daughters, and all fears and wants remove. Who can faint when such a river flows down their thirst to sink? Grace which like the Lord the giver never fails from age to offering, see the clouds of fire appear for a glory and a covering, showing that the Lord is near. Blessed inhabitant of Zion, washed in the Redeemer's blood, Jesus, whom their souls rely on, makes them king and priest to God. Savior, if of Zion city I through grace a member be, let the world deride or pity, I will glory in thy name, trading this the worldling pleasure, all his boasted pomp and show, solid joys and lasting treasure, none but Zion's children know.
Remain standing for the scripture reading. The scripture reading is taken from Psalms chapter 46, verses 1 to 10. Psalms 46, verses 1 to 10. I will read in your hearing. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore will we not fear, though the earth be removed, and though the mountains be carried into the midst of the sea. Though the waters thereof roar and be troubled, though the mountains shake with the swelling thereof, there is a river, the stream thereof shall make glad the city of God, the holy place of the tabernacle of the Most High. God is in the midst of her, she shall not be moved. God shall help her, and that right early. The heathen raged, the kingdoms were moved, he uttered his voice, and the earth melted. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. Come, behold the works of the Lord, what desolate he hath made in the earth. He maketh the wars to cease unto the end of the earth. He breaketh the bow and cutteth the spear asunder. He burneth the chariot in the fire. Be still and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the heathen. I will be exalted in the earth. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading of his word.
Good morning, everyone. Happy Sabbath. Please remain standing for prayer. Let us bow our heads. Our loving Lord and Father in heaven, to you, dear Father, we ascribe all praise, honor, and glory as we come into your presence on your Sabbath to celebrate this holy day. We're thankful, Lord, for the way you have guided us, the way you have provided, for you are the one truly who provides and protects. And so, dear Father, as we come into your presence to give you all praise, honor, and glory, we ask that you accept our worship today. Be with everyone in your presence. I ask, Lord, that we all desire to be in a closer relationship with you. And as we come not only to celebrate this Sabbath, but to celebrate life and to fellowship with each other, we now invite your presence and ask that you bless us in all things, we pray. In Jesus' name, amen. Please be seated.
Good morning and happy Sabbath to one and all. It is with great pleasure that we extend a warm welcome to our eminent guest speakers who will be speaking to us today. We would like to recognize in our presence the Honorable Silveria Jacobs, the Prime Minister of St. Martin, the Honorable Dr. Anders Rudolph Samuel, the Minister of Education, Culture, Youth, and Sport. And this morning, we want to say a very special welcome to all. We pause to contemplate in our minds, as well as in this place, God's unwavering grace and favor, as well as his presence today in this house of worship, wherein we thank him for his goodness in the life of our dear sister Barbara Richardson. We are glad that you are here to contribute to the tapestry of prayers, faith, worship that will be unfolded today. We thank you.
Yes, sir. get any music on? It's on now.
Sister Barbara Richardson Alexander, born and raised in an era of war, yet very calm and peaceful too.
Married in a world of conflict and independence. Married in a world of conflict and independence.
Yet faithful and full of grace.
Baptized in a time when the church was small and members were few.
Today, we welcome you to celebrate with her 100 years of a life well lived. Calm, peaceful,
faithful,
spirit-filled,
hardworking,
soft-spoken,
sister-chi.
Me now? Yes. Sounds better? Yes. All right. My name is still Lloyd Richardson. And my function here this morning is to direct the processes of what's going to take place here today. I want to personally welcome our Prime Minister. I must tell you that the Governor you that the governor has been invited to this function here, but lamentably, he could not be here with us today. And so at this particular point in time, I'm going to ask the Honorable Prime Minister, Sylvaria Jacobs, to come to the podium and present her congratulatory messages.
Thank you very much, Dr. Lloyd Richardson. Good morning, church. It is blessed to be in the house of the Lord this Sabbath and for this wonderful occasion. I'm so sorry that she's not here to hear, but I wanted to share at least these words on behalf of the government of St. Martin in honor of Mrs. Richardson. As Leviticus 19:32 urges people to stand up in the presence of the aged and show respect for the elderly and revere your God. To respect the elderly is actually to show your reverence for God. Take the time to listen to them, to their experiences and wisdom, to grow in knowledge, to allow yourself to grow in knowledge. Job 12:12 also says, wisdom is with the aged and understanding in the length of days. And so none of us know what time we have here on this earth. None of us know, especially in these difficult times, how long we will have to be on this earth and how quickly we see life transitioning for some of us. Every time we reflect on life, we know that we have a birth date and a date when we will leave this earth. But the dash in between is what is most important, the journey, the life, and how well we live it. How well we loved, how we shared, and how we impacted the lives of others and our world. Jesus' life on earth was a mere 33 years. Think about that. A third of what we're celebrating here today. And look at the impact that his life continues to have on all of us. So it is indeed a great, great honor to achieve a long, and certainly a long, long life, and certainly to achieve this milestone on achieving a centenarian in this family. Celebrating 100 years, and if I listen to the youngsters just now, a very good living. What a span of time to live, to love, and impact lives. If Jesus only had 33, imagine what this lady has done in 100 years. In what I can hear is humility, soft-spokenness, but in my personal interactions, a core of steel. I right, I wrong? A strong lady. A lady, but indeed very, very strong. To have raised strong children, impactful children, and ensured that her legacy continues to live through them and the grands and the rest. So indeed, for all of us gathered here today in celebration of our newest centenarian here on St. Martin, in the troublest of times, it is something indeed to give thanks for, to be grateful for, to say thank God for the life of Sister Barbara Richardson, for living her journey well and continuing to impact lives. On behalf of the government and people of St. Martin, as we recognize this honor and celebrate with you, Mrs. Richardson and the entire family, we wish her a very, very happy, special 100th birthday.
She's coming out now, so I'll... Just wait. We're going to take a little moment of silence as my mother, the centenarian, enters the hall. You may stand. Here she comes. You can give her a round of applause. She's going to move there to her favorite seat. That's where she sits every Sabbath. When we were in Aruba, she sat on the very same seat, but on the left-hand side. That was done to be able to control us from the seat. And when she went to the choir, we had to sit there so that she can, by, you know, just making certain movements, monitor your behavior. So here she is. Thank you very much. I did not get the opportunity to converse with the Honorable Chairperson of Parliament, and so by protocol, she should be called now, but if she wishes to defer a little bit, knowing that you've just come in, it's no problem, but it's your turn to come to the podium and say some words of welcome, greetings, etc., to the Parliament. Please. Mrs. Sarah Westcott-Williams.
Good morning, dignitaries. Good morning, church congregation. Good morning, family and friends, and a blessed good morning to Mrs. Richardson. Good morning and happy birthday. What a celebration. What a gratitude that we should be expressing as a community, as an island. Thank you, Dr. Richardson, for introducing me as the President of Parliament. But if I may take off the proverbial hat as such, and direct myself to the church and to Mrs. Richardson as Sarah. And I want to do so as Sarah Williams. And I want to do so as I take you back to Aruba. And I want to take those of you who know Aruba back to Royweg. And I want to take you to where we lived, right across from Mrs. Richardson and her family. And I want to take you to her house, a pink house on Royweg, just a few meters across from our house, and an almond tree in the front of the house, and a wooden bench under the almond tree, to which we had to attend Sabbath school under the tutelage of Mrs. Richardson. Mrs. Richardson, I want to thank you for those days, for those teachings, because I am convinced that because my mother believed that religious teaching had no church boundaries, and so I ended up having Sabbath school, that today I am the person who I am. Mrs. Richardson, thank you. Thank you. I don't know when either Mrs. Richardson and her family came to St. Martin, came back to St. Martin. I know when we did. I don't know who did first, but I can tell you one thing. I remember that pink house on Royweg, across from our home, the almond tree and a wooden bench in the yard, where we enjoyed Sabbath school teaching under the tutelage of Mrs. Richardson. This community is blessed. Mrs. Richardson is blessed. And guess what? We stand as a community in the shadow of those blessings. We enjoy them as a community because of Mrs. Richardson. Because every person, like myself, who Mrs. Richardson has taught, who she has encouraged, who she has supported in their endeavors, today we are enjoying her blessings. What a wonderful way to be able to say congratulations on your 100th birthday. What a privilege as a community to be able to join her on this special day. Now, Mrs. Richardson, I'm going to put on my Parliament hat and say on behalf of the Parliament of St. Martin, I bring congregations, friends, and family greetings and a very special happy birthday to Mrs. Richardson. May God continue to bless you and all those lives who you have touched. And may you enjoy several more years with us, Mrs. Richardson, as we stand in the shadow of your blessings. Thank you. God bless you, church.
Thank you very much, Chairlady Sarah Westcott-Williams and Sarah Williams, as you would like to be called today. We thank you for that. I remember these duties that we all had to go through because myself and my brother were the ones holding up the scroll so the lessons could be taught, whether we like to or not. So thank you again. We're going to pause a little moment now for a very special of music given to us by none other than Mervyn Butcher.
Me?
Give Brother Mervyn Butcher another round of applause. He has this suave voice that really soothes the soul. We are going to have a little skit now before we go to the other two dignitaries who are here to give your short message, we hope, to all of us here gathered today. I was told that, you know, but I forgot a little bit to push the mic a little closer, thinking that, you know, all we as Richardsons have very loud voices, etc., in plantation. Thank you.
Who's there?
Good morning, Sister Leontine.
Hi. What's up?
I just passed by to have you to help me to shell some peas.
Oh, look at that. No problem. I will help you. But the truth is, first, I have to get this piece of sewing done. So you can start, and let me thread this needle. As soon as I'm finished, I will dive in and help you, okay?
No problem, that's okay. What are you doing? You cannot even thread a needle?
Listen.
Let me help you with this.
Good morning.
Good morning. Hey, Sister Richie.
How are you?
I am fine. It's good to see you. What are you doing in my area, girl?
I'm just passing through.
Okay. You want to sit? She harassing me.
Okay,
what's
well, we have somebody that
ladies?
Can thread the needles. Sister Richie will help you to thread the
no
needle.
No way.
I am trying to thread this needle, right?
A needle you all cannot thread?
Sister Richie, every time I have this malediction here. See?
Give me this. Give me this.
Older than me, man.
Give me this, Sister Leontine. I'm 99 years old, and I will show you.
Oh, Lord have mercy. Here's the needle.
The thread, I just give you the thread. You drop it. Lord have mercy. Just give you
a... Let me show you how a 99-year-old does thread a needle.
Wow.
It's a lie.
Wow. And I didn't need the glasses. I didn't use glasses.
No.
You ladies are younger than me. You have to eat your carrots.
But you know how much carrots I don't eat since I small?
I don't know what you're doing wrong, but you have to eat your carrots.
Okay, I will try that.
I will
Come
eat some
on.
More.
The fruits are there for us. You see how healthy looking I am?
That's
good. At 100, eat your vegetables, eat your carrots. It is good for your eyes. How many times we have to say these programs in church? Ladies, please read your Bible. Follow the teachings. We always base our programs on health. Isn't that so, church?
I will eat some more carrots.
Start Because you are too young to use your eyesight.
You know, and I have all glasses, I still can't see. Wow.
It is shameful. Shell your peas. Shell your peas. Shell your peas. You can see light?
Yes, I can.
Okay.
I don't need my glasses to shell the peas.
Good. Going to, you guys are going to exercise good health, great health. It is important for us. You live long like me. I don't eat meat. I don't eat meat. I am vegetarian. So practice that so maybe you can live to see 150. Hey, 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 hey. Shh. What did you learn in Sabbath school? You should not run in church. Okay? Did you know that? Walk softly in the
sanctuary.
Say it again.
Sanctuary.
Walk softly in the sanctuary. I know your mommy taught you better than that. Don't ever walk in the sanctuary, run in the sanctuary again. Okay? I am not laughing. It is not a joke. Okay? We are serious. This is where God dwells. Okay? Now go find your mother. Little children.
Sister Richie, since you're here, we had planned that we were going to go by Sister Frances. We want to visit her, you know, community services.
Okay.
And we want to sing some hymns with her.
Okay, let's start.
Should we practice?
Nope.
Okay, let's go.
I know every song in the hymn book.
All right.
Let's go.
Hymn number 100.
Great is thy faithfulness.
Oh, wait, no. But you know the title already.
Oh, yes, let's sing. Tell me if it's correct. You need glasses?
You're right, you know, it's great is thy faithfulness.
Let's go. Great is thy faithfulness, O God, my Father. There is no shadow. Wait, you all need the hymn book? I don't need a hymn book. I know this song by heart.
That's good.
Ladies, study your Bible. Know the songs. A time of trouble is coming when we will not have to use this again. I am so sad for my church. I am very sad. I cannot believe in this day. And did you guys grow up in the church?
Yes.
Yes, how do you don't know that song?
I know the song.
Okay, but you don't need the book.
Well, to be honest, I do need a book.
The glasses to read for the book.
Put the book down. A time of trouble is coming. Great is thy faithfulness, O God, my Father. There is no shadow of turning with thee. Thou changest not.
Thou changest not. Thy compassion they fail.
Do not put it on the screen. As thou hast been, thou forever will. Great is thy faithfulness, church.
Great is thy faithfulness. Great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see.
All I have need.
All I have need thy hands have provided.
Great is thy faithfulness.
Great is thy faithfulness, Lord unto me.
Learn your hymn books. Learn the song.
So it's my joy. It is my wish that we all make it into heaven.
That is so. I wish that I had that kind of remarkable remembrance that you have. As long as you start singing the songs, I can join in. But when you call the songs like that by the number, I will not be able to tell you the title.
You know what? God bless you. You know what causes that?
What?
Consume your fruits and vegetables. Consume your fruits and vegetables. Stay away from the animal products. Stay away from the meat. Stay away from everything that is detrimental to your health. Will you do that?
Yes.
I am 99 years old, 100, and I am thankful to my father. Now let's
God
go.
God bless
come.
Your heart.
Come and learn. Come and learn.
We
come
will. Learn. We will follow you.
It is a shame.
We thank the ladies for that skit. It was a beautiful skit, right?
Yes.
I think it rightly represented my mother.
Yes.
You agree with that?
Yes.
All right. We know how it is. And now we'll go back to the ministers we have with us here today. The Minister of Education, Culture, Youth, and Sports. None else but the Honorable Rudolph Samuel. Jim Tucker Boy. All right. Welcome.
Good morning, church. I am indeed very honored and happy to be able to say to Mom, Miss Richardson, a happy 100th birthday. Happy birthday to you. Now, when you hear Lloyd say, Jim Tucker Boy, it puts everything in perspective. So if you were to deduct 50 years, and we go back 50 years ago, then you know I was a little boy. And as a young boy, around 10, one of the things we did were we ran through the hills. We climbed the hills. So we knew every fruit tree, everyone. At some point in time, I saw something happening in Sucker Garden. All of a sudden, in the area there, by the well, we saw excavating taking place. We saw big tractors coming in. We saw big trucks coming in. And then we realized a new family was in Sucker Garden. Shortly after that, we saw the cutting of the hill. And you know, as young boys, you would be watching and looking and all these dump trucks coming. And after the cutting of the hill, there came this house when they have flattened out a big area. So things changed because as a child, you know, you could not just go in other person's fruit trees. You just couldn't go in the yard. Not even if the yard wasn't fenced, you had to have manners. So was the time the kinnips was in the tree, and this was a special kinnip tree, but someone is living there. So we come and we look and we look and we don't see no one outside. So we go by the front door and we call in, hello, hello, nobody. And then we go by the side door, by the kitchen, and we call, and eventually someone comes out. And very soft-spoken, we would ask, can we pick some kinnips, please? And just waiting for one answer, yes. And then we get our chance to pick the kinnips. And these little things are things that we remember and we cherish. And when we come down, most naturally, we have to give some to mom and make sure we didn't dirty the yard. And I want to tell you this morning, I look at you, I look at you, and I said many times, it is not what people say, but the way they live. And just from looking at them, you can adopt the message of how you should go through life. I want to ask God to continue to give you health and strength, and I wish you many, many, many years. I know that's your favorite place in church, because when I'm there, you're over there. And I want to say, church, we are blessed to have her with us here today. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Honorable Minister of Education. Last but not least is the Honorable Artwell Edion Richardson. He's part of us. So we are going to call him now to the podium. He's bringing his mother. That's the Richardson, you know, yeah. And so I'm so glad to have them here today. So please present us with a little word here. Thank you for being here.
Thank you, Dr. Lloyd. Good morning, church. Good morning, Sister Richie. Happy birthday to you. I'm gonna say happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
So,
Sister Richardson.
So I don't have any stories from Aruba like MP Westcott Williams, but I do have stories from my at home where Sister Richardson was my grandmother's best friend, Miss Maud Richardson, Naomi Richardson, and. I said, I always ask my mother, how come you're both Richardsons but being family? Could we never call each other cousins? And my fondest memories of Sister Richardson, I would say, anybody that knows me knows I like food. So, see, Lucho laughing already. So, but before we get there, I would say this. What I've also learned from Sister Richardson is that she's a definition of what family is, not just church family, but also biological family, but also family that's meant to be, because Sister Richardson showed me what a best friend was supposed to be like. Every Sabbath, every night, they would stay hours on the phone together. I wish they had a WhatsApp back then, because the phone bills would be less. We had a very high phone bills back in the days. And every week they would come, I don't think I've ever saw them angry at each other. I've never seen them even raise their voice at each other. And I think that's a very, very rare thing to see in our day for sure. And when I would come back home from college and would come back to church, I would always wonder if she remembered me. She was one of the first people to have a bright smile on her face. Welcome back, welcome back. And then I would go home a couple of days later, my grandmother would say, hey, Sister Richardson, send this for you, food. And one of my favorite things that she used to make for me was a corn pie. So every Sabbath, a lot of Sabbaths I would sit down, both Richardson families would come over by us or we by them, and she would always make this corn pie. And no one has been able to replicate this corn pie since then. So I haven't eaten it since then. Hint, hint. And she would always, when I come back home from school, she would always make it for me. And she was basically like a second grandmother to me. And she would always talk to all of us, my brother, my cousin. Even my brother would say, boy, Sister Richardson, don't forget me, self, boy. No matter where you are, she would make sure come and visit you. You could be in the road, you could be in town. Oh, and my birthday, yes, that's true. She has the best memory, because I'm horrible with birthdays. If it wasn't for Facebook, I would not remember birthdays. Sister Richardson will always message you or call or even send a letter or a card for your birthday. I don't know how she remembers everybody's birthday, but that's another gift that she has. I don't know how she does it. So on behalf of the Richardson family, I know my grandmother would love to be celebrating with you today. I would like to say, Sister Richardson, happy birthday and many, many, many more laughter-filled, joyful, healthy years.
It is almost 9:30 or 10:15 minutes. We have promised that we would give the dignitaries who are here with us today the time to alight if they could not stay any longer with us. We're glad to have you. We wish you could stay for every last item, but we know that life, especially your lives, demand a little more. And so at this point in time, if there any one of you, dignitaries I'm speaking to now, that would like to exit, then just indicate. Would you, are you staying? Yeah, okay, then we have no problem. They will do so. They want to stay with us, and we're glad to have them. Thank you very much. Just wait one moment as the next item is being prepared. Okay, they're not going, so what's the next one?
No, Omar. Oh, then let's go.
Thank you. now be able to see. We will now be able to see a video recording from the president of the North Caribbean Conference. Here in Methodist circles, it will be the synod, you know, who basically governs this area also. Who also governs St. Martin as far as Adventism is concerned. President of the North Caribbean Conference, Pastor James.
Honorable members of Parliament and other distinguished guests, Pastor Vashni Kuvale, pastor of the Phillipsburg Seventh Adventist Church, Dr. Lloyd Richardson and other members of the Richardson family, esteemed guests, family and friends, members of the church, and most importantly, our guest of honor, Mrs. Barbara Richardson. Today, I join you as we gather in the warm embrace of celebration, surrounded by the echoes of a centuries with memories, wisdom, and unwavering faith. It is with immense joy and profound gratitude that we mark this remarkable milestone, which for us is both an aha moment and an iconic milestone. The 100th birthday of Mrs. Barbara Richardson, a true beacon of light to the church and to her community. I wish, like you, that we could have been eyewitnesses to this moment, because as we celebrate, we find ourselves not only celebrating the passage of time, but also honoring the indomitable spirit of a woman whose dedication to God and to her church and to her community and her fellow human beings has been unparalleled and with grace and devotion. As a young pastor, I always admire the dignity, the grace by which she performed her work and carried herself. Mrs. Richardson, yours is a journey marked by unwavering commitment, compassion, faith, and resilience. Imagine, for one century, you have been a pillar of strength, a source of inspiration, and a living testament to the power of faith and love and unwavering dedication to your beliefs, your tireless efforts to uplift those in need, and your boundless kindness, and they've all touched countless of lives and left an indelible impression on all our hearts. In a world where time seems to move at an ever-escalating pace, your centennial birthday serves as a poignant reminder of the beauty and the significance of a Christian life well-lived. I believe, like all of us, your journey has been filled with triumphs and challenges, joys and sorrows. But through it all, you have remained steadfast in your resolve and unwavering in your faith. Today, as we gather to honor you, Mrs. Richardson, we do so not only to celebrate the passing of your years, but to celebrate the richness of your life, the depth of your character, and the tenacity of your service, and the profound impact you have had on all who were privileged of knowing you. Your presence among us is not just a cause for celebration, it's a source of inspiration, a beacon of hope, and a testament of the enduring power of the love of God in a Christian woman. And so today, on behalf of the administration of the North Caribbean Conference, yours truly, the Executive Secretary, Pastor Wilma James, the CFO, Ms. Sunita McKenzie, and from the 15,000 members scattered across our 12 island territory, I extend to you heartiest congratulations on this momentous occasion of your 100th birthday. May your birthday be a day filled with joy, laughter, and the boundless love of those who hold you dear. As we reflect on the journey that has brought us to this moment, let us look to the future with hope and anticipation, knowing that your life serves as an enduring legacy, that faith, hope, love, and perseverance, that with faith, hope, love, and perseverance, anything and everything is possible. Mrs. Richardson, happy birthday. May this day be as extraordinary and as unforgettable as you are. Congratulations to a life well lived, a legacy that will endure for generations to come and many more years. And if you can grant me the privilege of having a wish, my wish on your birthday is that one day when the giver of time shall change time into eternity, yours may be granted the joy of having everlasting life to live forever and ever and ever. On behalf of all of us to you, congratulations and happy centennial birthday.
Thank you very much, Pastor James, for your tributes. We will now have the Sabbath School Community Service and Women's Ministries will follow unannounced with their tribute. Thank you.
Good morning. Happy birthday, Sister Richie.
Thank you.
On behalf of the department, now this morning we will be presenting 100 roses to Sister Richie, and this will be coming from the different departments of the church. So this morning, in my capacity as the community service leader, on behalf of my entire team, we want to present you with 10 roses. We're going to place it in the basket for you because it's going to be too much for you to hold.
Sister Richie, I represent the Sabbath School Department, and this morning we want to say thank you for your dedicated service to the backbone of the church. We want to thank you for your hard work. We love you.
Sister Richie, good morning. I'm very happy to see you. I know that. On behalf of the Felixburg Women Ministries Department, I'm offering you 10 roses and an extra gift. There's always extra with women. So this one I'm gonna place at the feet of the table where we have the roses for you. And then I'm gonna say a little something, but let me put these down first. Sister Richie, today we celebrate you as a woman, as a mother, as a teacher, as a friend, as a mentor. You have been all these roles and so many more to so many women in the church and in the community. I am not sure you are aware of the impact you have had and you still have on us young and a little older alike. Your memory has always baffled me. So many of us also. Even today, she never misses a birthday. And my own felt so special because I'm born the same day of one of her sons. So even though she forgets me, her son and I have the same birthday, so she always remembers me. Psalms 90 verse 10 says that man has 70 years and by reason of strength, 80 to live on this earth. Oh my, you have outpassed them by 20. Because the purpose that you have been given by God lives on. May God keep blessing you as you celebrate on behalf of the Felixburg Women's Ministry. Enjoy the milestone and God's ever grateful mercies. Happy birthday.
We also would like to present this bouquet, and it's coming from the President of Parliament, Mrs. Sarah Westcott Williams, to you, Sister Richie. You're welcome. I've said it on her behalf.
We will pause a little bit with the departmental greetings and recognize the Honorable Minister of Health, Social Affairs, and Labor, Honorable Omar Otley. Glad to have you here, sir. We welcome you to the podium to extend a few words of greetings to the community.
Good morning, good morning. With this job, you always gotta be ready. one thing I have noticed during my tenure, I've been blessed to come to many, at least four or five of these celebrations, which means that we have real pillars in our community. People that have seen things far more than we can imagine. Far, far more. I am grateful to be in your presence. I can only imagine how blessed your family is, how much stories you have to tell them, the way that you see St. Martin change. For me to hold your hand truly, truly gives hope, and I hope that one day we could be celebrating my 100th birthday. Nothing. Just staying pretty. She asked me what I have to do now. I said, just sit and look pretty. You have to teach me the secret. But definitely, thank you. Thank you to the family for the invite. And on behalf of myself, the Honorable Prime Minister, the Council of Ministers, we extend well wishes and many, many more. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Minister Otley. The Prime Minister still have a little treat to deliver. We'll allow her to do this in short fashion.
Mrs. Richardson, you weren't here when I said the few words, but I wanted to say on behalf of Government of St. Martin, we honor you for your legacy that you continue to live and the impact you continue to have. I enjoyed listening to the children as well as the ladies depicting who you are, and I think what you embody within you is something we can all hope to emulate no matter how long we live. Congratulations on achieving this centenarian life of 100 years, and may God grant you wisdom, courage, love to continue to impact us all. for many more.
Thank you again, Madam Prime Minister. We will continue with the departmental greetings, and we will have three other groups, the Children's Ministries, Youth Ministries, Deacons and Deaconesses, who will make their departmental greeting now. Thank you.
This morning, I say hallelujah. 100 years. And still moving. Misael? Come. Misael is a product of Christian education. Put him in there for me. The thing is on. Okay, I guess I go on without the presentation. When I see Sister Richardson, we call her mom, grandma, I see Christian education. You may ask why? Because Christian education is for now and through eternity. There's no end to it. One of the elements of Christian education is prayer and family worship. And these are traits of Sister Richardson. If you have ever spent a night in her home, no matter the time you went to sleep, you had to wake up to have worship. Prayer is an intricate part of her life. She prays in the morning, at noon, at night, and even in between time, she prays. Sister Richardson also believes in community. This morning, Mrs. Sarah Wiscott-Williams is a witness. She gave to those who were in need. She clothed them. She fed those who were hungry. She never forgot your birthday or your anniversary. And what I liked about her birthday is no matter what it was, it could be pizza, it could be a banana, it could be an apple, it could be a mango, whatever it is, you will get it on Sabbath morning, or your parents will go to her home and pick it up. She believed in community, even under the tree. She spread the gospel to her neighbors, to us who were not her birth children, but we feel as if she gave birth to us. You could never beat her VBS. You had to learn to crochet. You had to learn to sew. It was not a 1 week VBS, it was 2 weeks solid. Teacher Richardson, this morning, we salute you as your children. She believed in academics. She sent 5 of her children to Seventh-day Adventist school, and they're well represented in the community. Not only that, but she also sent other students to Christian education. Gardening is one of her favorites. She loved to garden. And in her garden, she would implement new start, nutrition, exercise, water, sunlight, temperance, rest, air, and trust in God. That is why this morning she could have walked to come up the step, because she believed in a new start. I want to encourage all of us this morning to take up the challenge with the new. Sister Richardson, this morning we love you and we do appreciate you. She believed in family, she believed in God, and she also believed in education. But my ultimate desire for you today, Witness Network, when Jesus comes, you will not just see him, but you will sit with him forever.
Sister Richardson, I am here on behalf of the Family Life Department of our church. And this morning, we are so pleased and happy to wish you a wonderful happy birthday. We also want to let you know that we do see and recognize the blessings you have received by deciding to live out a Christian marriage and also by your commitment and dedication to having a Christian home filled with Christian values and principles. Today we see that your children, your grandchildren, and your great-grandchildren, whether by blood or by heart, call you blessed, and by extension, us as your church family. So today we want to say thank you again for being a living example and for continuing to be an example of the blessings that can be shared and can be given to each and every one of us should we decide to live up those Christian principles. Thank you again, Sister Richardson.
Sister Richie, I am so blessed to be alive and at this time of my life to know you and to be in your presence. Some people admire movie stars, they admire song stars and want to be like them, but me, you are my mentor. I want to be just like you. Even sometimes when on Sunday nights, when everybody seems to say, no, I'm tired, Wednesday night, man, it's middle of the week, I can't make it to prayer meeting. But me, when I remember Sister Richie can make it to prayer meeting, and on Sunday night, I just drag myself. I say, I have to be in church. Sister Richie is in church, so I have to be in church. I am younger. So I admire these qualities, and the other day I was saying, I feel you translated already. Because the way you live and the way you keep yourself and sometimes you get little mishaps, little accidents, and you just bounce back. And the last time you had a little mishap, you end up walking more straight than before. So I tell myself, this lady, she's just yeri for somebody, but she's translated. But I just want to be just like you, and I praise and I thank God for knowing you at that time of my life. And we're on the same birth month, we have to be good people. We just have to be good people. God bless you.
Sister Richardson, I'm nervous. I don't know what to say. On behalf of the deacons and deaconess, myself, Sister Francis, and the rest of the deacons who are in the congregation, we want to wish you a happy 100th birthday. May the Lord continue to bless you. I was telling one of my brethren last night, I don't want God keep me to 100. I want to die 75 or 80. But God is so good to you, and congratulations. When I first became the head deacon, you motivate me a lot, because when I could see you come Wednesday night, Sunday night to church, it encouraged me to try my best to be here. And if you could do it, I think all members can do it. So congratulations, and may God continue to bless you until he returned.
Thank you for your beautiful flowers.
You're welcome, sister.
Men's ministries and the elders are going to come now to do their departmental greeting, after which a neighbor, Eleanor Letang, is a neighbor in the room.
Martin, you know, she will be coming to sing. It's special for us. So you didn't hear me again. All right. We're going to have greetings from elders of this church and the men's ministries, after which a lady who just, she's laughing, lived as neighbors to us, just to the east, she's going to come and sing. At that point in time, as far as we were concerned, she couldn't sing, but she can sing now. Oh yes, and she's going to come and sing and say her part, okay? Thank you.
Sister Richie, on behalf of the men's ministry and the Sabbath school class in which you sit, which is named the Roses, we can offer you roses. It's such a pleasure. They say what goes around comes around. I sat in her class many years ago in Aruba, and she's now sitting in my class on St. Martin. Sister Richie, a happy birthday.
Sister Richie, on behalf of the Board of Elders, I want to celebrate with you this morning as God has blessed you with 100 years. The Bible says in Psalms 92, verses 16, with long life I will satisfy her and show her my salvation. What a blessing it is to live for 100 years. I wish, by the grace of God, I would one of these days. But if not, we know our destiny is not to just to live for 100 years, but is by God's grace to make it into heaven. And I pray that as you have dedicated your life to follow Christ in all righteousness, we too, by the grace of God, will continue to remain faithful and true, that when Christ comes, we will go home to live eternally with him. God bless you, and do enjoy your birthday.
While Eleanor comes to us, we will have, following her, the Colby Seventh-day Adventist Church, then Ephesus SDA Church, after that St. Peter's SDA Church will come in that order unannounced.
To those of you who don't know me, my name is Eleanor Blenman Letang. You know me? Okay. I must tell you, I was 6 years old, and Sister Richie was my neighbor. I grew up in Sister Richie's home. I played with the children. We sang, we ate, I think even slept, vacation Bible school, Brand Sabbath school, and church. She took my mom to church and encouraged her to become a Seventh-day Adventist, and my mom became a Seventh-day Adventist. I later moved to New York City, and before I went to New York, one day, Barbara, you remember what Eleanor did? I took a big rock. I was very adventurous. I took a big rock, and I found a big, long piece of wood. And I put the wood on top the block, Barbara on one end, and I'm on the other end. And when we looked, boom, Barbara was down, a broken hand. Eleanor caused Barbara to get a broken hand. I went on to New York, I got married, and when I came back, I would go by Sister Richie. I spent many days up there, and because I had nothing to do, came back to St. Martin, and she taught me to make gluten. And I admire her because on Sabbath, Sister Richie would bring flowers always to church, even from Aruba. And you know what? Today I am a florist. This is my work. I love it. Because I learn to play with flowers, put them in my hair. I took them to school. And I must say, Sister Richie, she knew everything about me and the children around, those of us who were in the neighborhood. Now, back those days in Aruba, when you go to school, if there was no teacher, you had to go home. Let me see who from Aruba, anybody here remember those days? There were no substitute. So I used to like to go up the steps by Lago. And by the time I reached home, Sister Richie already knew school was out, and Eleanor did not come on the straight road back to Roihundu because I went up Lago Heights Road. My mother, who was working by the time my mother got home, the rod and the staff was comforting me. Thank you, Sister Richie. You see, she laughed. She remember. Linda said this morning, Linda Richardson, I went by Sister Richie and she said to me, you was Apple Girl. She remembers. And I must say also on behalf of Ruth Connor, because of not being well, she cannot be here this morning. She asked me to extend happy birthday to Sister Richie. And way from California to John and Lloyd and Ovid, to the guys who were the mechanics from Randolph Premdas, who drove the red Mustang. Congratulations to you guys. And I would like to present this to Sister Richie. So this is among the 100 roses. So that means next year we'll be back. God's day life. And I need some help. Thank you. You can hear me now? Yeah, this was her 99th birthday, and I would like for you to give her that presentation for me, please. And Sister Richie, may the Lord continue to bless you, and may you live for many, many more years. Now, you all know I sing, right? Huh? Y'all don't know I sing. Okay, I'm gonna try something very different this morning. Very, very different. I would like for everyone to please stand. Everyone, please stand. Why are you telling me no? This is in honor of my, this is my mother. This is my mother. Okay, music.
Hallelujah, for the Lord God omnipotent.
Hallelujah. For the Lord God omnipotent reigneth. Hallelujah. The kingdom of this world is become the kingdom of our Lord and of His Christ and of His Christ, and He shall reign forever and ever. He shall reign forever and ever. God bless you to my mother, Sister Barbara Ritchie. God bless you. Thank you so much.
Good morning, church. Happy Sabbath. Sister Richie, God bless you. We are here from the Ephesus Seventh-day Adventist Church. And I want to say, when I first came to this church, you were very instrumental in making sure that I get to know the God that you love so much. And when I listen to other members, I'm not going to say the young generation, because we are younger. Not young, younger, Sister Richie. This morning we are here celebrating with you and giving God thanks. Psalms 91:16 says that when you are older, that the Lord will bless you and He will give you, He will show you His salvation. And this morning, we are celebrating with you. We are giving God thanks for the years. Sister Richie is an example of what God will do for us when we choose him as our God. This is the example we have here this morning. So we give God praise and we give God thanks. On behalf of the members of the Ephesus Seventh-day Adventist Church, we want to give you this little gift of appreciation just to let you know how much we love you. God bless you.
Thankful this morning for my children, the children of the church that I taught from since they were little. So I'm thankful to the Lord that I was able to take care of these children and to see them grow in the church and become teachers in the church. God bless all you.
Amen.
Okay. Well, I thank everybody in this church for the blessings they taught me. Because whenever I come to church, you're here. And if you weren't here, I had nobody to talk to. No. So God bless all you again for coming to church and coming on time. So when I reach, I see my children. So I call you all my children. Yeah, so many children that are taught in Sabbath school. And now I can see that they are big and they can teach me. Yes, they can teach me. So God bless all of you, every one of all of you. I'm so happy to see all of you. You won't believe how happy I feel.
Thank you, Mom. Thank you. Thank you. Yes. We will now have the Jeffers family to make a little presentation to you, Mommy. Okay, they're coming now.
Sister Richie?
Yes.
This name is affectionately called by this generation. Now, on behalf of the Phillipsburg SDA Church congregation,
we celebrate our centennial. Sister Richie, you have exhibited all the fruits of the Spirit as recorded in the Bible. And so we all as a congregation are still feeling those fruits. And today, on behalf of all of us, we salute you and we are presenting you with this odd token of appreciation and your basket of fruits to continue strengthening your eyesight, continue to strengthen your bones, continue to help us to feel your love until. Remain faithful, our mother in Israel. We love you. We love you and we appreciate you, Sister Richie.
I love all the children. I don't know which one I don't love. I love all of them, all of you. And I want to see all of all you grow up in the church and be like me.
Thank you, Sister Richie. Thank you. May God bless you.
We're moving right down now, it's coming to the end. But before we do so, P645. You're blocking the entrance of someone looking to alight. In other words, to leave the premises. Could you please assist them by removing your car? I think you would find some other parking space within the compound. At this point in time, there's going to be recordings from Orrin Watley and family, Hetty Green and family, and my children. Please look at the screen from wherever you are. I hope you can get a good view of them. Thank you.
Happy birthday, Sister Richie! You're reaching 100 years old.
We're going to come and see you soon.
Maybe you'll reach like 1,000.
All right, bye.
Bye.
Mama Barbara, Sister Richardson, Sister Richie, hartelijk gefeliciteerd op deze bijzondere mijlpaalverjaardag. Namens mijn broers John en Randolph, mijn zusjes Ria en Seika. Ook namens allen die u in lang vervlogen jaren op Aruba gekend hebben. If my mother, your dear friend Elsa Green, was alive, she would surely serenade you. Allow me my adapted version of Count Your Blessings. Never mind my croaky voice. Grandam Richardson celebrates 100 years with thankful heart and radiant health amidst her offspring so dear. Loved, respected, esteemed by many far and near. Honored today by young and old around the globe. Siblings, in-laws, kids, grands, great-grands rejoice with her. Church family and community surround her here. Sweet St. Martin and Aruba too. Home sweet home for grandma and her crew. Richardson generation 4 and 5 counting happily by. Duna, dankina, Señor. Thank you, Jesus. Love, Duncan, and answer here. Masha Pabieng, enjoy your birthday weekend. Lloyd, John, James, Barbara, Daphne, Allen, van harte gefeliciteerd met jullie grand dame, centenarian Barbara Richardson.
Hi, Grandma, and happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
What a blessing it is to make it to this milestone. Through these 100 years, you've been a daughter, sister, wife, mother, friend, and so much more. You were a pillar in the village that raised us. You gave us time to play, you put us to work, and when we went astray, you were always there to guide us back to the right path. You had perfect attendance at church. At least, anytime I was there, you were there too. People could and would rely on you to always be there, and of course you always were. You brought children to Jesus through Sabbath school, and to this day, no one has been able to capture my attention by use of felt board like you did. You cared for all who needed it. You fed those who came and were hungry. Your house was a safe place, and at times, a sanctuary. You selflessly gave your own space to others in need. One such example is when you shared your space for our drum band practice. Not just did this offer us a healthy outlet, which was much needed for us as young people at that time, but through this outlet we were able to minister to the community around us. I could only imagine what it must have felt like to hear constant banging and noise, sometimes even daily, building up to a performance while trying to live your daily life in your home, but you never made us feel guilty or indebted. Actively and passively, you contributed to so many lives. It felt like just the other day that we were there under that big kinnip tree. Memories at Grandma and Grandpa's house will forever be etched into our minds. Precious moments that can't be replaced by any pleasures of this age. Congratulations on an incredible 100 years. Say happy birthday.
Happy
birthday, Grandma.
Happy birthday, Grandma. Congratulations on 100 years of life. We wish that you'll have the best birthday ever. We know birthdays are always very special. You made sure our birthdays were celebrated with either your famous pizza or cake. Of course, I always chose pizza until you went totally vegan. But thank you for all the amazing memories that you've given us over the years. We hope that you will enjoy your day. We're so sorry we can't be there to celebrate with you, but we know the family will do it justice. And I ask that God will bless you immensely for everything that you've done for us and everything that you've been for us throughout the years. Enjoy your day. Love you.
1, 2, 3.
Happy birthday, Grandma.
Hi, Grandma. Just wanted to say happy birthday and congratulations on reaching 100 years. I miss you, and I miss the days when we would all come up to the hill, from family gatherings to worship, to drum band practice, and even walking up the hill to you after school at M. Genevieve. You had a part to play in some of my earliest and fondest memories. You and Grandpa always took care of us, and I thank you for that. I miss you. I hope you enjoy your birthday, and again, congratulations.
The praise team will come to you next with the last song. We are going to try to join up with them so that you can hear some of the voices of offspring of my mother. and after that, Sister Alice, one of the superintendents, will have the last remarks. Thank you.
6:23.
When we all get to heaven. Let us stand as we sing.
Sing the wondrous love of Jesus. Sing His mercy and His grace.
Please be seated.
May the peace of God be with you as on your special day. May his gift of grace surround you as you follow him in his way. May his blessing rest upon you and his wisdom guide you today and always. And may his peace surround you. Sister Richardson, happy birthday. This morning I take the opportunity in thanking each and every one of Sister Richardson's friends, family, and church family to this special moment. It has been a blessing to see someone celebrate 100 years. Some children do not even reach 15 and they're dead. And God has blessed her, and we thank you from Phillipsburg Seventh-day Adventist Church in joining us today to celebrate this special occasion. We are not finished yet, but after the service, we are having a nice celebration at the back, so we are inviting every one of you to please stay with us and fellowship with us. God bless you, and you could visit us next Saturday at the same time. God bless you.
To this special occasion where we are celebrating the 100th birthday of Sister Richardson, better known to us as Sister Richie. I saw a custom of calling her Sister Richie. I don't even know her first name. But that's what I know her by for the past 30 years, I think, or 25 years. So all of you have taken the time and found it important to leave your busy schedule, your regular schedule, to come and make this occasion special. Everyone in this room this morning and online, your presence, you being here today, is making this an occasion. And I thank you for being here. This is also the Sabbath day where we come and worship our God. And today, we welcome you to this service. So here, relax, enjoy, worship with us. The Phillipsburg Seventh-day Adventist Church welcomes you, you who are present and you who are online. Thank you for being here.
Thank you.
Amen. Lovely memories. Hymn number 100 will be our hymn of continuation. Great is thy faithfulness. One of the favorite songs of Sister Richie. Great is thy faithfulness. Kindly stand.
Deacons, please prepare for the morning offering. Jesus quoted these words in Luke 6, verse 38. and it say, give and it will be given to you. Good measure, pressed down, shake it together and run it over where they give unto your bosom. For with the same measure you measure, it shall be measured back to you. These is the words of the Lord. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, eternal God, this morning we want to thank you for your holy Sabbath day. Most of all, we want to thank you for us as members, friends, and brothers and sisters celebrating the 100th year of Sister Richardson. We want to give you thanks. And Lord, as we give you thanks today and glorify your name, we ask you, Lord, as we are about to give our tithes, return our tithes and offering for your cause, we ask you to bless it, O God. May it be for your missionary, and your name will be glorified. So as the deacons prepare to give, to pick up the offering, God, may your Holy Spirit be with them, guide them through this walk. We ask you in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
As the offering is being picked up, we just want to let the owner of P2583 know that your alarm is going off consistently, so you can attend to your vehicle. Thank you so much. P2583. Thank you.
now going to have our scripture reading. I would like each and every one that is able to please stand for the scripture reading, which is taken from Philippians chapter 4, verses 4 to 7. Philippians chapter 4, verses 4 to 7. Rejoice in the Lord always. And again I say, rejoice. Let your moderation be known unto all men. The Lord is at hand. Be careful for nothing, but in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known unto God. And the peace of God, which passeth all understanding, shall keep your hearts and minds through Jesus Christ. Amen. Please be seated.
For praise and worship, we will start with one of Sister Richie's favorite song in Dutch, entitled Gezang, meaning sing.
Grote God, wij loven u.
Only one verse. I was ready to sing the next. We're going to now sing hymn number 27. Hymn number 27, another favorite of Sister Richie.
Yes, on
Sing the chorus, I will serve thee because I love thee, followed by He is Lord, He is Lord. And then we move into our prayer song, which is Amazing Grace. We sing meditatively.
I will
because I love thee.
I will serve thee because I love thee. You have given life to me. I was nothing like me.
Time when the church is called up to pray, and I'm asking you to please stand as we approach our Maker. And I want to ask the parents and students, those who has to do their exams in the coming weeks, I'm also asking you to draw nearer to the altar as we petition on their behalf. If you are impressed, just walk a little closer to the altar as we speak to our God. Let us please kneel before our Maker. Our eternal Father and our God, we want to thank you for this holy Sabbath day. We pray, O eternal God, that you forgive us for our sins and our shortcomings, O Lord. As we present ourselves here before you, we are weak, but we ask, God, that you'll strengthen us by the power of your Holy Spirit, dear God. We want to thank you, Lord, for you, how you have graced us through this week. You have blessed us, we have went out, we have labored, and we came back, O Lord, at our home safe. And we are here to give you thanks and to worship you in spirit and in truth, dear God. So we pray your blessings upon us. Father, I bring before you this congregation. I ask, O dear God, that you be with every individual, dear Father God. Be with each and every family, Father God. Father, I pray, O Lord, for the celebrants among us, in particular Sister Richards, who have come to this milestone. We pray, dear God, we thank you in the way that you have graced her up throughout these years. We pray, O Lord, that you continue to be with her and with her families. I pray, oh dear God, also for different other families, oh Lord, here tonight, this afternoon, that you continue to be with us and give us the strength to worship you and honor you in the way that you have designed, Father God. Continue to be with us as we go through the sessions of this day. We pray, oh Lord, for the pastor who will bring the message to us this afternoon. We pray, oh dear God, that you'll grace him, and may you continue to direct his path, O God, as we preach to us this day, O Lord. We pray, O Lord, for the students, O Lord, who are going to do their exams in the coming weeks, that you will give them the unction to function, O God, that they may be able to excel. I pray. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
The speaker of the hour we've been waiting for. He is a man of God. He has devoted his life in doing the will of God. And he is always willing and ready to assist the church wherever he can. And today he has prepared a message for us with the guidance of the Holy Spirit. For those who don't know him, he is no other than our pastor, Pastor Vashily Kuvele. Please give him your undivided attention as he presents the word of God to us. But before he do so, we will first be blessed with two special items. The first will be from Brother Moses Alexander, and the next will be from the Kanagita sisters. And then the next voice you will hear is from our pastor, Pastor Vashily Kuvele.
Good morning, church. Good afternoon. Doing this song especially for Sister Richardson. I am not a Richardson, but I am a son. She has adopted me ever since I came into this church. And she has always looked out for me every single year. I remember she never missed my birthday until I passed 50. But she has always been a source of encouragement to me. When I went through a rough time, she encouraged me. And then she told me, listen, I'm very glad you remained faithful. And I'm faithful and I'm glad for her encouragement. Continue to bless her with many more years to come.
That one was specially dedicated to Sister Richie from the leadership of the church. And now the Kanigita sisters will render one from my family.
The Savior has come in his mighty power and spoken peace to my soul. And all of my life from that very hour I've yielded to his control. I've yielded to his control. From grace to grace every day, and brighter the glory dawns when pressing my homeward way, while pressing my homeward way. Wonderful, it is marvelous and wonderful. what Jesus has done for this soul of mine. The half has never been told.
Amen. You know, singing, I often say singing could be so good in this sinful fear. Imagine what we'll be like when we get over there, when there's no sin. And I'm looking forward to join the choir. You know, I can't sing now, but I, you know, the Bible says we're going to be changed in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye. Yes. Protocol has already been established. And so I will just get into the word. I won't be long. And just want to share with us, viewing life through the lenses of gratitude. Viewing life through the lenses of gratitude. Let us pray. Loving God, as we are about to open your word, we pray that your Holy Spirit would come divine, mighty near. Speak through me to your people. In Jesus' name we pray. You know, sometimes it's moments like these, I wish we could have just sing the benediction and go home. It was a good morning so far. But what a joy it is today if we gather on this Sabbath day to celebrate on this special occasion with Sister Richie, Barbara Richardson. To give God thanks for allowing us, or loving her, rather, to reach that milestone. And, you know, Sister Richie still attends all the services and, that the church has and all the functions. And she's still in her rightful mind, and we say, to God be the glory. Amen. Sister Richie, as she is affectionately known, you are surrounded this morning with your children who love you dearly. Your grandchildren, your great-grandchildren, relatives, friends, members, and well-wishers. You know, I call her the mother of all mothers here at Phillipsburg. The mother of all mothers, since she is, you know what, the eldest among all of us. Thank you, Sister Richie, for being a role model to all of us, both in the church and in the community. Your loving, caring contribution to our church and the community has inspired a positive change in many. Your lifestyle of following the 8 laws of health, being a vegetarian, has contributed to your longevity. We thank God he has given us the opportunity to know you, and may your influence, your positive influence, continue to lead others to Jesus Christ. Growing older gracefully is dependent on maintaining a positive attitude regardless of life circumstances. Whatever life brings our way, our attitude will determine how we will deal with it and how the outcome will be. You know, celebrations are occasions that we focus on the meaning of life and the goodness of life, and we can recall life's blessings. You know, it's often said if we don't count our blessings, we'll be only adding to our sorrow. And my question to us this afternoon is, have you been counting your blessings? Huh? Have you been counting your blessings?
The song says we must name them one by one, and you'll be surprised to know and see the things God has done and he will continue to do for you. You know, I've heard that there are two types of blessings. There is that which is called general blessings, according to Matthew chapter 5, verse 45. And it says, "For he maketh the sun to rise on the evil," or the just and the unjust, and he's the evil and the good, and he sends the what? The rain on the just and the unjust. And so ever often, beloved, as you drive through St. Martin, you would realize that sometimes Phillipsburg experienced a heavy downpour, a heavy shower, or probably Belvedere and Dutch Quarter and nowhere else. And I want to thank God that he is who he is. You see, because if God was like you or me, God would have loved the rain just to fall on certain people, and you don't want it to fall on another person to receive that blessing. But God is not like that. He said he sends the rain on the just and the unjust. He is a loving God. He's a fair God. He's a just God. And then we have what is called personal blessings, which come in the form of spiritual blessings and material blessings. You know, God has been good to all of us, and too often we only count our blessings in material things. But beloved, how many of us, we haven't even visited a doctor's office for a year. That's a blessing from God. Beloved, celebrating 100 years in a positive way, and it calls for an attitude of gratitude. It says a farmer was sitting on his porch one evening. He was married for 50 years. And as he was reminiscing, he turned to his wife, and he realized what a good wife he had had, or she is rather. And so he turned to her and said, "You are a great woman, and you have been a great wife. All these years, you have meant so much to me." And then he was reminiscing that in his mind, and then he turned to her and said, "Honey, you have been a wonderful wife, a good mother for all of these years." But that's the first time he has said it to her. You see, beloved, we all have gratitude in our hearts, but it never comes out at times. Beloved, gratitude is not thanksgiving until it's expressed. The Bible tells us in 1 Chronicles chapter 16, verse 34, he says what? "Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good, for his mercies endures forever." One cannot instantly become grateful or thankful. You only become thankful when you are habitually practicing or having an attitude of gratitude in your life. It doesn't come like that. The Bible tells us in James chapter 17, chapter 1, verse 17, it says that everything, every good and perfect gift comes from God. Beloved, we will grow closer to God when we understand truth and build our lives around it. We express gratitude, or we must express gratitude regardless of the situation we find ourselves in. Why? The Apostle Paul tells us in 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 18, he says, in every situation that we find ourselves in, we must give God thanks. Somebody didn't hear me. I said, we must give God thanks. You see, because we cannot see the full picture. We cannot see beyond. And in spite of the command to be thankful, you would agree with me that we are living in an unthankful society and an extension world. When we are unthankful, we are a danger to ourselves and others. You say, well, why, preacher? You see, beloved, unthankfulness leads to bitterness, complaining, and murmuring. They are the products of an unthankful heart, a heart that fails to recognize God's infinite wisdom, grace, and purpose. And let me show in this. When we are unthankful, beloved, we dishonor God. You don't agree with me? Beloved, I said, when we are unthankful, we dishonor God. Beloved, we cannot sit and look at a situation and understand why something is happening or why the situation turns out the way it did. We can only trust God according to Romans chapter 8, verse 28. It says what? In all things work together for what? For good. To them that what? To them who are called according to his purposes. You see, beloved, God is at work in every situation. God is at work in every situation, and God is working things out for your good and mine. I'd like to direct our attention quickly to Genesis chapter 37, a familiar story that we are all well acquainted with. Joseph. Now, I'm not going into all the ramifications, just going to touch a few points here to make the point that I'm making. Joseph's brothers hated him because of the favoritism his father showed towards Joseph, because Joseph was the son of his favorite or his beloved Rachel. Joseph was sold as a slave to Midianite merchants. And I believe, beloved, you know the story well. And as Joseph was moving from Canaan on his way to Egypt, all the familiar hills were just disappearing before his eyes. And I believe Joseph was wondering, what will my future be like? But beloved, the Bible says, but God was with Joseph. Many of us think because the Lord is good to us and we have dedicated our lives to him, only good things will befall us. But beloved, there's nothing further away from the truth. In Egypt, the Midianites merchant sold Joseph to a man by the name of Potiphar, who was in charge of the Pharaoh, who worked for Pharaoh, the Pharaoh. He was the Pharaoh's captain of the guard. And you know, beloved, I believe that Joseph was quite a handsome young man. And Potiphar gave him everything. He said, you will be in charge of everything in my house. The only thing or the only person I'm going to withhold from you is my wife. And I believe probably Mrs. Potiphar heard it, and because Joseph was handsome, and so she began to make all sort of sexual passes at Joseph. But Joseph was determined not to sin at any cost. Mrs. Potiphar continued to entice Joseph. Lie with me, nothing's going to happen, no one will know. Beloved, but I want to submit to us, everything that happens in the dark, God sees. Others may not see, but God knows. And that's why Joseph said, how can I sin and do this wicked thing and sin against my God? And so, beloved, because she didn't get through, she began to, she accused Joseph of trying to rape her. Joseph was thrown in prison. Was God still with Joseph? Was God still with Joseph after this thing happened? I believe Joseph was wondering, beloved, if we learn to wait on the Lord and trust him, we will not have so much extra things to worry about. We would not be stressing out ourselves. We have to learn to trust God. I'm closing. A number of men were traveling by a ship and they encountered angry seas and the ship sank and only one survived. He was washed up on an island, an uninhabited island. And so he prayed feverishly that God would send someone to rescue him. So every day he would scan the horizon looking for help, but nothing was seen to be coming forth. Exhausted as he was, he built a little hut out of driftwood to protect him from the elements and his few belongings, the few possessions that he had. And beloved, one day, as he was out hunting for food, when he returned to his campsite, he discovered that the little hut had burned down and the smoke was just rolling up to the sky. And he turned and he said, "But Lord, why have you allowed this to happen to me? The worst have happened." Beloved, he had lost everything. He was stunned with disbelief, grief, and anger. You know, sometimes I want to let you know, God has a way of working, but we shouldn't be angry with God. And even though things do not work out the way how you planned it, I want to let you know, God is still in control. So, beloved, do you think God have a sense of humor? Yes. Of course, God must. You know, some folk think God is just serious like a judge. God has a sense of humor. Beloved, early the next morning, he was awakened by a ship approaching the island. They came to rescue him. And so he turned to them and said, "How did you know I was here?" He said, "We saw your smoke signal." Beloved, sometimes if we would only wait on the Lord and learn to trust God under all circumstances. But you see, sometimes things happen in our lives and it's often said when one door closes, another one opens and we stand. Brother Rolox, that's you there? And we stand looking so long and regretful at that closed door that we don't even see when God opened the other door. Beloved, whatever situation you find yourself in, give God thanks. Because he is in control. God bless you.
We will turn to our closing hymn, 310, from our old hymnal, "Oh Happy Day That Fixed My Choice." Understand?
Oh, happy day that fixed my choice on thee, my Savior and my God. Well, may this glowing born. Happy day, happy day, when Jesus washed my sins away. He taught me how to watch and pray and live rejoicing every day. Happy day, happy day, when Jesus washed my sins away. 'Tis done, the great transaction done. I am my Lord and He is mine. He drew me and I followed on. Jump to confess the voice divine. Oh, happy day, happy day, when Jesus washed my sins away.
We would like to express condolences to the Carty family on the passing of Mr. Carty. Lunch will also be served in the Hugh Building after service. Now, unto the King, let us bow our heads. Now, unto the King Eternal, immortal, invisible, the only wise God, be honor and glory forever and ever. Amen. You may be seated.